Welcome to the Bonhams Auction here at the 32nd International Classic Motorcycle Show at the Royal Bath and West Showground near Bristol, Shepton Mallet. This is the first time that Bonhams have held an auction here. There's been one or two others in the past, but this is the first Bonhams one. So we're just going to have a quick look around at some of the bikes. And most of them have come out of a collection called the Chichester Collection, and there's some really interesting things. So it'll be nice to just have a quick look, and it's going to be interesting to see how they do. Right, now this is the first lot in the auction. It's 1947 KSS, so we're just going to have a quick look at it. Mark II KSS, which you can tell by the fact it's got fully enclosed kind of valve gear at the top end, which is something that Velisa introduced on the Mark II. Rigid rear end, of course, pretty much indistinguishable from the pre-war KSS, really, which was different from the KTS. In so much as the KTS Cami Touring Special had a 19-inch front rim, whereas the KSS had the bigger front wheel and the briefer front mudguard, as this one has. This one hasn't obviously been used for some time, but was apparently quite a favourite of the owner, Mr. Chichester, whose collection is that's coming under the coming under auction today. Pretty nice thing all round, and I'm quite convinced it'll do much better than the pre-sale estimate of £3,000 to £4,000. Right, this is a 1955 Series D Vincent Rapide. It's only had one owner since 1966, and by the tax disc, it's clearly been off the road since 1991 as well. So quite a nice unspoilt bike. When you have a look at it, the differences between the D, which were the last of the Vincent twins, and the C are things such as the Series C and all the B's, all the postal Vincents before that had the oil tank within the main frame member, whereas the D, they switched the oil tank to underneath the seat. Likewise, this lifting handle for the stand was introduced on the D as well, and quite a lot of people have actually fitted them to early events as well. It's a really good stand, very easy to use. All in all, this is a really nice unspoilt bike. Things like the sprocket on the rear wheel, where you could swap it around for different gearing, so the wheel could be fitted either way. And of course, being a Vincent, the wheels come out, no spanners needed. You just got the adjustable, the kind of quick release Tommy bars on them. All in all, pretty nice Vincent. The polished forks aren't right, but quite a lot of people did that. Again, a bit of a 60s thing, polishing the front forks because they're aluminium. Really, really nice thing. Right, this is probably going to be the star lot in the sale, really. It's a 1932 680 Black Alpine Brough Superior. Now, it's not, I mean, it looks very much like the SS100, which is the 1000cc version, but this is the 680, slightly smaller V-twin engine, but still a Jap J. Presswich motor. This one, Bentley and Draper frame, which is early suspension and has fitted to a lot of the Broughs. A really nice kind of untouched thing. It's been languishing in the collection for many, many years, and it's going to create a lot of interest and excitement. So it'll be interesting to see what it does. Originally, it would have had this kind of black, kind of crinkle finish, which you can see sort of existing in bits and pieces, and the tank as well, with the lovely embossed logo and what have you. So it is quite a project. There's quite a lot to do, but there's already been, this morning as we've been stood here, there's been a lot of people looking at it, a lot of interest, and it's going to be going to surely attract some fevered bidding, and be quite exciting to see what it does. Okay, this is a 1960 Rumi scooter. This is the Boldore one, which was the kind of special racy job, and this one is made even more interesting and special by the fact that it's been owned by the same guy from brand new, 1960. He used it in all sorts of scooter events during the 60s, what have you, and then it's seemingly been kind of hidden away for years and years and years, and has only just come to light. It's a fantastic thing in so much as it's just like a time warp. It's not been touched since goodness knows when. Aluminium bodywork, and of course the fantastic roomy 125 twin cylinder two stroke engine, little flat twin, ever so smooth. And all in all, a lovely little bike. It's a bit of work to do, but it will be a very rewarding project. These things are supposed to be capable of something like 80 mile an hour, so for a scooter that's not bad going, especially a 125. Right, now this is a couple of examples of the less shiny bikes that are in the sale. We've got a 1930s OK Supreme, and next to it a Royal Enfield, probably a ex-RAF or something like that, military Second World War job. The OK is essentially all there, so it's going to make a fantastic project for someone. It seems to all be there, but as you can see, it's a little bit rough around the edges, although fairly sound. The kind of still some sort of remnants of the original logo, etc., on the tank. OK Supreme was a company owned by the Humphreys family, Ernie Humphreys being the man behind it. A few ups and downs during the 1930s, but they made some really attractive bikes, and this is one of them, or at least it will be when it's restored. I mean, the interesting thing about a project like this is that there's no real alternative other than to restore it. The Royal Enfield is possibly a little bit different in that you might be able to use it as it is with just kind of a bit of a rub over with an oily rag, etc., but it's borderline. As you can see, there's quite a bit of rust coming through, although most of the metal is seemingly quite sound. But if we just swap back to the OK, that's, you know, there's no other option there apart from it's going to have to be a proper strip down, a rebuild. But it's, you know, it's all there. Clearly, yeah, all the cables, etc., all look fairly nice and original. It's bits and pieces of bodges that have kept it on the road in its day. Whether or not there's a tax disc on it, I'm not sure. We'll just pop around the other side and have a look in a minute. But it's interesting thing, and it would make a lovely project, and surely someone will take it on. Right, I'm here with Ben Walker, head of motorcycle sales at Bonhams. We've got about 2.5 hours to go now before the start of what's the first Bonhams sale here at the Bristol show. So how's it all looking, Ben? It looks busy.
It's certainly that. I actually am a little bit overwhelmed by the number of people who have decided to come along to the sale, but it's all good. There's some fantastic bikes here, and let's face it, everything is priced to be sold, so it should be an exciting afternoon.
What sort of estimates have we got on the bikes here? I know you've got low estimates on things to basically get people in, but what are the reserves? Are the reserves low as well?
Majority of machines here, especially from one particular collection, the Chichester collection, are going to be sold. There are no reserves on those motorcycles. Whatever they get to this afternoon, that is what they will sell for. But you've got prices ranging from 100 quid for a Cycle Master up to, you know, £28,000 to £35,000 for a 680 Brough Superior.
And we both know that the Brough is probably going to sell for considerably more than that, so we shall wait and see, but, you know, hopefully it will. Hopefully
never,
it will.
Never take anything for granted.
See, Ben is always a naturally cagey man, and we're quite confident the Brough will probably do a bit more than that, but we shall see, and we'll have a chat with him afterwards to see how he thinks it's gone. Right, we're here in the Bonhams auction, and we've seen the first three or four lots go through. I think we're on to about number 7 at the moment. The first lot estimated in the catalogue was 3,000 to 4,000, and it was knocked down for £8,500. So that's giving you some idea of the tone that's been set. The second lot was a Velocet Venom that went through a lot more than was expected. So it's looking like the guys are in for a good day.